We on? Yeah. Oh, there we go. I got a box of goodies. So, here's the deal. I have the tent that I said I was gonna do, the video on. I also have a hammock set up. The reason I have a hammock set up is because I have talked Mel into going camping with me again. The reason she hasn't been camping is because she doesn't like to sleep on the ground. So she used to go camping with me. At some point she called it. So with all the trips I've been taking, she's going to try the hammock, see how that works out. But I have to take this stuff out and my gear bag out anyway because we're going to Ocala this weekend. And the ticks out there, I've heard are really bad, so I'm going to spray it down with the Premeth and stuff. At least some of the outside of the stuff. Maybe not the tarp or the hammock, but at least like the bottom part of the tent maybe, and shoes and some gear and our packs. But that's a good time to do this video and the update that I will be taking Mel this weekend camping because it's not hot anymore in Florida. And we have the hammock. There's a few people from the bushcraft group coming to meet us, so we're good to go. So this is a Lynx. It's hard to see with my sunglasses on. So it's a Lynx 1. The numbers usually mean how many people can fit in it. So this is a one person backpacking tent. And this is what John used in the Utah trip with me, as well as the Montana trip. So it's really cool. You can see it packs down pretty low. I'm probably gonna strap these to the bottom of my pack so it doesn't go in my pack. And my quilt actually has a similar roll, so I may end up with a full roll on the bottom of my bag. But everything fits in this nice little pouch. I don't actually know how heavy it is. It's not very heavy. It's pretty easy to put together. I just kind of hodgepodged the roll together after taking it out to dry it when I got back. So you just kind of unroll the dude. This is, in here is the, I'm not gonna use this, but this is the footprint. That's in it, fits in a very small, I'm gonna use it when I camp. I'm not gonna set it up this time, so. There's that. In here is some various stuff. The tent stake and the little, this attaches to the top. And you can hold your gear in it. That fits in its own little bag. You can stake it out. I'm not probably not gonna stake the rain fly out this time because I just wanna put it up. And the way the system works is pretty cool because all it has to put it together are these two tent poles. Start on this side. They're the standard, like, snap together tent poles. This is like the second time I've put this thing together. I like how small it is, and it's screened in, so I won't need the bug net. I don't know how Griff's gonna do. I'm gonna take my tarp just in case, but with Mel in the hammock and then me inside the tent, like, I don't know if he'll be a crybaby or not, or if he'll just sleep next to the tent. I don't know. Okay, so this unfolds. And on the bottom of this thing, let's see if we can get it in there. Okay, so there's two holes, and that's like close or far you can put the poles in. And then the clip is for the rain fly, like it clips in on the edges. So you just take these poles and cross them diagonally across the tent. And I'm gonna use the outside ones for this. It's got a little edge in there, but sometimes it comes off, but there's a, like a little lip that you can stick these in. I've seen this done two ways. Either step on the sides or just do one at a time. I'll try and step on this. Okay, so, oh, nope, didn't work. I'll put this one in and then do the next one. So there's no like sleeves or anything it has to go through. No sleeves. Just these little grommet dudes. And like I said, it's got a little seat you can see in there. So if you keep some tension on that, it won't pop back out.
spine. Just get this together. Okay, so that's basically
the frame. Then there's hooks on this that just hooks up to it. So once you hook the center one in, you don't have to hold it or anything more. That's the frame. There's a bunch of clips, like three on each side, that go down it. You can see it starting to make form up now. So if you use the closer holes, it's not quite as rigid, and the farther ones make it a little bit tighter. Okay, and that's the tent. Side door is here. This is your in and out door. Screened in on the top, on the sides. So that's gonna keep the bugs out and stuff. Then, like I said, the fly just kind of snaps on. I'll get it out. So you just take the door, and you find where the door is on this thing, which is a zipper. And you can find these clips just snapping in. One of the reasons I didn't want to put it up is because of the sand in the yard. Okay, so it's got guy lines and stuff, but essentially you pull this out, fit this together, and you can stake it down. And that's like the vestibule area. And it has some guy lines, and there's a little vent on top. And then I believe there's stuff underneath so you can actually hook it harder to the poles. So this is the tent I'm going to be using. Then you can roll those dudes back however you want. So this might be how... That might be how I end up in it, so the drift doesn't freak out. And then for the hammock. This is cool. Like, I hope she really likes it. If not, I have a new hammock. Okay, so this is Grand Trunk Skeeter Beater. It has a mosquito net on it. It's got a picture on the thing of the mosquito net. You can look it up. It's got the dimensions on it. Weight is 35 ounce. Capacity is 400 pounds. There's at least two people I know that have seen camp in these, so it gets voted in. Then a Chill Gorilla. It's the tarp and the stuff that goes with the tarp for like the rain. And then I also got a couple of trunk straps so that I don't have to mess with the cordage or anything. And then the underquilt that goes with this, I believe, is also Chill Gorilla. And this is like 5 Celsius to 20 Celsius. So that'll be, Mel gets cold pretty easy, so that'll be what we put underneath of it while we're camping. She gets cold out here now, even during the day. And then we'll take various, like I have a quilt, but we got my big Agnes, and then she's got a fleece blanket that I bought her. We'll take that, just see how things go. We're mainly interested in how well she sleeps in the hammock. And then if not, like I said, I got the hammock, that hammock with my big Agnes sleeping bag. I can take just about anywhere, but really the ease of setup of this, and then knowing it's not a winter tent, but I've seen someone use it in the winter, and it's better than, like, I was laying under a tarp. So with the pad I have and the Agnes bag that I have, anything's a cold weather tent. There's not a whole lot of room in there anyway, so it's just kind of getting in. I can put the bag under the rain fly when it's staked out. And it's really just for sleeping, so I wouldn't want to be stuck in there for too awful long, but then again, when I got stuck under my tarp, I didn't move out of my sleeping bag anyway, so probably plenty of room. So anyway, that's the stuff. Hopefully we get some good videos with the tripod and fair weather here. It's going to rain Sunday morning, but Saturday is supposed to be good. We're going to go for breakfast Saturday morning. The two guys I mentioned that also camp in this hammock, so they're going to show me. I didn't do any test setups or anything because I have experienced hammock people going. We did watch a couple videos and then saw how to lay in them like diagonal, but we'll figure that out when we get there because we're going with experienced people. We have all day and then probably part of the day Sunday, so we should get footage. Someone that's going with us is also trying to get YouTube creation, so we'll have lots of opportunity for the kind of video stuff. So hopefully I get some good footage of that. So that's this weekend. And then after this weekend, I'll be hopefully editing a good video and I'll show you how all this gear works out in the field. So that's it.
See ya. Bye.